to tell us that he was no longer the skinhead that participated in that or any other heinous act.
I was a hypocrite, a bigot, a hate monger. I was just as evil as anyone of the rest of us. Dumbasses around here. So I wasn't always a good person.
In 2004, while awaiting trial, he not only renounced his gang affiliation, but decided to tell all.
I've pulled people's covers who weren't known. I've given up information on other crimes. I'm not held back. I renounce publicly through doing interviews like this. I've renounced with officers, I mean, to every extent. I've ruined myself. I've made it public knowledge. I've made it to where everybody knows. I don't have a chance to go back to that lifestyle. I don't want to go back to that lifestyle.
In fact, he even works with some organizations to combat racism.
I'm a source of information to the Southern Poverty Law Center, to One People's Project, anti-racist action. I've done all I can to change myself as a person and not only to renounce and to become a hermit from that lifestyle, but to actually take an opposition against it.
But there was a price for coming clean.
You're basically deemed a snitch, so that's why my custody is what it is. If I'm ever put in general population, I'm as good as that.
Any prison gang would be happy to get their hands on Sean Gates.
It's kill or be killed for me now, so I'll spend my time in protective custody. More than likely, slam down the entire time.
While his public confession may have put Gaines' life in danger, it also generated some welcome attention from the inside world.
Apparently, I'm writing my fiancé.
You're the fiancé?
Yeah.
Is this someone you meet before you're incarcerated?
No. That matters since I've been here. The interview I did with Southern Poverty Law, she actually read that and just wrote a couple posts commending the changes I've made and such. So, we've been friends for almost 2 years now and been together for about